Welcome to the Sportsturf Scoop, brought to you by Penn State Center for Sport Surface Research. In this edition, we will be discussing the potential for athletes to contract staph infections from playing on synthetic turf. Staphylococcus aureus is a common bacterium that often lives harmlessly on the skin or in the nose. However, if staph bacteria enter the body through an open wound, it can result in anything from small skin lesions to major health problems or, in extreme cases, even death. One particular type of staph infection, MRSA, which stands for methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, is resistant to antibiotic treatment. As a result, MRSA infections are difficult to treat and can be fatal. After several high-profile outbreaks of MRSA among athletes, including some that tragically resulted in deaths, the role of synthetic turf in these outbreaks has been questioned. These outbreaks have led some to claim that synthetic turf is a breeding ground for bacteria. Over the past several years, MRSA outbreaks have resulted in the temporary closing of facilities including synthetic turf fields. A number of antimicrobial products specifically designed for use on synthetic turf have also entered the market. At Penn State Center for Sport Surface Research, we conducted a series of studies aimed at evaluating the potential for synthetic turf to play a role in staph infections. We visited 20 synthetic turf fields throughout Pennsylvania, including several indoor fields, and tested each one for the presence of staph bacteria along with the total microbial population of each surface. On each field, we took samples from high and low wear areas. Along with the synthetic turf fields, we also tested two natural grass surfaces, one sand-based and the other a native soil field. This figure shows the total number of colony-forming units on each surface. Colony-forming units refers to the total microbial population on the surface, not staph bacteria specifically. On synthetic turf fields, we saw a range of 0 to 80,000 colony-forming units per gram of crumb rubber. Interestingly, the total number of colony-forming units on the natural grass fields was drastically higher than on any synthetic turf field. It is important to note that microbes tend to be present on many surfaces we come into contact with, and the simple presence of microbes should not be cause for concern. When looking at staph specifically, none of the fields in the study tested positive for the presence of staph bacteria. In addition to synthetic and natural turf, we also tested a number of other surfaces. We positively identified staph bacteria on human hands and faces, along with several areas in a locker room, including blocking pads, weight equipment, used towels, and a stretching table. So our survey found staph bacteria on several surfaces commonly in contact with athletes. However, we did not find staph bacteria on synthetic turf. In our next study, we inoculated synthetic turf with staph bacteria and monitored how long it survived, along with the effectiveness of several control agents. We conducted this test both indoors and outdoors and included natural grass as well. The control treatments we evaluated included a cationic surfactant, which was Sports Clean, an antimicrobial product called Sports Aid, and Tide liquid detergent, which is an anionic surfactant. The outdoor series of studies also included Downy fabric softener, which is a cationic surfactant. Complete details of rates and timings can be found in the full report available on our website at ssrc.psu.edu. We conducted outdoor testing on three separate occasions during the summer. We found that bacteria levels quickly dropped to very low levels, making it difficult to evaluate the effectiveness of our treatments because bacteria populations on the control plots drop so quickly. Overall, bacteria survival rate was similar on both synthetic and natural turf. Under the conditions of our studies, ultraviolet light from the sun and high surface temperature seemed to be the most effective disinfectant. Now, for the indoor portion of the test, staph bacteria survived on both synthetic and natural turf for several days. However, the bacteria did not appear to thrive under the non-extreme temperature and limited light conditions. Bacteria population decreased significantly with time. Commercially available antimicrobial treatments, along with detergent, significantly decreased the survival rate of staph bacteria, although every experimental unit tested positive for the first 4 hours after inoculation. Some tested positive up to 9 days after inoculation. Commercially available detergent and the cationic surfactant Sports Clean applied around the time of inoculation resulted in no live bacteria detected after 24 hours. So, while some have claimed that staph bacteria thrive on synthetic turf, our research found that bacteria populations significantly decrease with time, and populations rapidly decline under sunny conditions. While the effectiveness of treatments in the outdoor study was difficult to determine because the population of bacteria quickly declined, several treatments did reduce staph populations in the indoor trial. So while synthetic turf was proven to generally be an inhospitable environment for staph bacteria, synthetic turf can play a more indirect role in staph infections. While certainly an improvement over earlier generations of synthetic turf, today's turf systems are still somewhat abrasive and are more likely to cause breaks in the skin than natural grass. So because staph infections are typically spread from person to person through skin breaks, additional skin breaks could increase risk of infection. Data from a 2004 study did indeed show that epidermal injuries and skin breaks were 9 times more common on synthetic turf than natural grass. So based on current research, staph has been shown to be present on surfaces commonly in contact with athletes. However, it has not been found on synthetic turf, and there is no evidence of anyone contracting a staph infection directly from synthetic turf. Overall, synthetic turf does not appear to be a hospitable environment for staph bacteria. Full reports of our staph-related research, along with all of our other research, are available under the research section of our website, available at ssrc.psu.edu. Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Sports Turf Scoop. As always, check us out on Facebook and Twitter.